Welcome back to Chemistea Time. In today's lesson, we will be continuing on with Lewis structures and learning about formal charges and their importance. In addition, we will also begin talking about resonance structures. Before we continue with Lewis structures, let's talk briefly about, you guessed it, exceptions. Earlier we introduced the octet rule and how most atoms are in the most stable state when they have a full octet in the outermost shell. There are some specific exceptions where atoms can be stable with less than or greater than 8 electrons. Boron is one such exception. Typically, boron only tends to form 3 bonds with a total of 6 valence electrons. This property is mainly due to boron's small size and lack of valence electrons. On the other hand, some elements can facilitate more than 8 electrons. We call this an expanded octet, and you will most commonly see this with elements in periods 3 and beyond, such as with sulfur and phosphorus. The reason sulfur and phosphorus can have an expanded octet is because they have access to the d orbital. This allows both elements to be stable with an octet, but phosphorus can have up to 10 electrons and sulfur can have 12. With this in mind, try drawing these Lewis structures: boron trifluoride, phosphorus pentachloride, and sulfur hexafluoride. Here are the correct structures so you can check your answers. Another such exception is when there are an odd number of electrons. This results in the presence of unpaired electrons, which we call radicals. An example of this is seen with NO2, which has 17 valence electrons. This results in an unpaired electron on the nitrogen. When drawing Lewis structures, it is sometimes possible to write more than one arrangement, and it can be hard to determine the most reasonable structure. In these types of situations, we can use formal charges to help determine which structure is the most stable. Formal charges are a way to calculate the charge distribution within a Lewis structure and is calculated for each individual atom in the molecule. It is important to remember that formal charges are fictitious charges and do not represent the true charge on an atom, but it is a way to predict the most likely structure. To calculate formal charge of an atom, we use the following formula. Formal charge is equal to the number of valence electrons minus parentheses number of non-bonding electrons plus bonding electrons divided by 2 end parentheses. Remember, non-bonding electrons are the lone pairs or electrons that do not participate in the formation of a bond. Bonding electrons are the electrons participating in the formation of a bond. Each bond has 2 electrons. When determining the most stable structure based on formal charges, the structure that has no charges is the most stable. However, in some cases, you'll have charges present, so keep in mind that you want your most positive formal charge lying on your least electronegative atom, and your more negative formal charge lying on your most electronegative atom. When you add up all the charges in your system, ideally you want the fewest number of formal charges. Let's do a problem and use formal charges to determine the most stable arrangement of carbon dioxide, CO2. For the following structures, let's calculate the formal charge for the leftmost structure. In this case, carbon is singly bonded to an oxygen and triply bonded to the other oxygen. In this case, both oxygens are bounded differently to carbon, so they will have different formal charges. Let's start with the leftmost oxygen and use the formal charge formula. Oxygen has 6 valence electrons, 6 non-bonding electrons, and 2 bonding electrons. When we calculate this out, this oxygen has a formal charge of negative 1. Carbon has 4 valence electrons, 0 non-bonded electrons, and 8 bonding electrons. The formal charge for carbon is 0. The rightmost oxygen has 6 valence electrons, 2 non-bonding electrons, and 6 bonding electrons, which equates to a positive 1 formal charge. If we add up all the formal charges, they equal 0. Let's go ahead and calculate the formal charges for the second structure, which has carbon double bonded to 2 oxygen atoms. It is important to note that both oxygens are bounded the same to carbon. This means both oxygens will have the same formal charges. Oxygen has 6 valence electrons, 4 non-bonding electrons, and 4 bonding electrons, which equates to a formal charge of zero. Remember, both oxygen atoms will have the same formal charge because they are both bonded similarly to carbon. Carbon has 4 valence electrons, 0 non-bonding electrons, and 8 bonding electrons. The sum of all the formal charges is equal to zero. Out of the two structures, the second structure, where carbon is double bonded to each oxygen atom, is the most stable arrangement. Both structures had a sum of formal charges equal to zero, but the first structure had charges on the oxygen atoms, whereas the other structure, all these atoms had formal charges equal to zero. The Lewis structure with the least formal charges on the atoms is the most stable structure. As we continue to discuss Lewis models, it is important to remember that models are a simplistic way of visualizing something complex. In some cases, molecules can have more than one valid Lewis structure, such as in the case for ozone. If we look at these two structures, they are both very similar to one another, except for the fact that they differ in the position of the double bond. This is known as a resonance structure, which is when two or more valid Lewis structures can be constructed for the same compound. In the following case, both structures are correct, but Lewis structures are not able to appropriately describe resonance. In nature, the molecule is an average of both structures. Resonance structures can be depicted with a double-sided arrow between the structures. In Lewis theory, electrons are localized either as a lone pair or as a bonding pair. However, in actuality, electrons can be delocalized over several atoms, which simply means that the electrons are not associated to a single atom. Delocalization of electrons helps stabilize the molecules by lowering the energy. When dealing with resonance structures, it is important to remember that the actual structure is an average of each resonance structure. You must be wondering about how formal charges contribute to this. Well, we can use formal charges to determine the best resonance structure that contributes most to the true structure. But it is still important to note that the actual structure is still an average of each resonance structure. This hopefully sheds light on how these simplistic models can give us a lot of information on molecular structures. I hope you enjoy today's lesson and have a wonderful day. Thank you.